Welcome to the hydraulic press channel. Today we are going to test some springs with our 40 ton press and 150 ton force sensor. So the idea is to press the springs as flat as possible and then see from the force sensor how much force it takes. And if you thought that the last week's video was a bit dangerous, this is even worse. So hold my beer and I'm going to explain how we are going to do this safely. So we have on both sides 10 millimeter polycarbonates. Then we have some extra plastic on top of the press in case it flies there. And then I have now two strings so I can press and unpress with strings. And we are going to go outside and far away from the building. And we are going to watch the happening through mobile phone stream. So it can't fly out. And if it flies out, it doesn't matter because we are far, far away and outside of the building. And there is already spring inside. That's car spring. Then we have this. It's like van spring from Ford Transit. And then we have downhill bike spring and then some homemade springs from copper, aluminium and silver. So I think we are going to start with this and let's hope that it stays inside of there and we don't break any cameras, but we are safe, that's sure. Here we go. Is the meter doing anything? I think no. No, let's start. Okay. Okay. I think that our safety straps that prevent the expensive force sensor flying, they are messing up the results. So we have to remove those. And then we try again. Okay, so new try and let's hope that the sensor works better this time. Okay. I think that the problem is that our sensor is just too large and it's a bit confused about the spring, so it can't measure so small amounts. I think that minus 360 kilos, I think that's like probably relatively close. I think it's probably around 500 to do that. But let's throw bigger spring there in case we got any better results. And then the smaller springs we are going to test with the smaller sensor that is much more accurate. Okay, so the van spring is now in and the sensor seems to work now better. I think it was a bit uneven load on the last one and that messed up my sensor housing thing. But now we should get some readings and this looks really dangerous, so don't try this at home. Hey, it finally worked and the maximum load, no, that wasn't the maximum load. I think it was around 780 kilos, so pretty much. And I think if the spring has slipped out from there, it would be really bad. And that's why we are here on our own, On the bigger press, it's really hard to shield completely, and there is a lot of expensive stuff in the workshop, so we had to do it here. Yeah, and then we are going to switch to smaller sensor and smaller springs. Okay, and then the downhill bike spring, and now we have smaller sensor, so it should be more accurate. And I put some rubber pieces on under and top of the spring, so it doesn't want to slip so easily out. But again, we are going to be outside, and there is a lot of polycarbonate on every direction. Okay, so here we go. I think it's flat now. Let's go have a look. Okay, so I think we crushed it more than enough. It was completely closed. And I have no idea what kind of force it took to close it. You can probably see it here. We had only like a WhatsApp video call out from the shop to see, and that wasn't so high quality. But, there is quite good dents here. It's like it sunk pretty deep there, but I think the spring itself is completely okay. And this feels really, really tough. You can't close it by your hand like almost at all. Yeah. And then we are going to try the homemade springs. Okay, first homemade spring. And these all are made from welding filaments. So I'm not sure about exact grade of the materials here. But the first is some kind of copper. And I think this feels really bad spring. So I'm not sure is it even 1 kilogram. And all of the springs are made by lathe. Just spin the material around like spinning shaft. Yeah, but first one the copper, and I think we are okay with just safety glasses with this one, no need to go out. Okay, I call that that's 0 kilograms. But it didn't break. Yeah, and then the aluminium. Yeah, so bit stronger material, and this is also much thicker. But I think this is going to be still really weak. But let's see, can we measure it with the press? Okay, so first major accident of the day. Luckily nobody died. But I would say that this is probably, it doesn't want to go in a like straight way at all, but I think this is already like maybe like couple kilos, so not very good at all, and I think they don't make springs out from aluminium at all. If you want lightweight springs, then they are carbon fiber or titanium, whatever. And then the most weirdest spring ever. I had some like welding silver left, or it's not welding, it's this thing that I don't remember now. It's leftover pieces that I have welded together to make long piece. And after seeing those, I think we don't even need to like use the press. I can just estimate by hand, this hand press channel. Yeah, this is maybe 200 grams. I would say that it's same as the copper. And if you want to see more spring crushing, there is our old video on the description and end screen. We crushed with more force, but we didn't have sensor then. And yeah, I think that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. And for today's extra content, we have this phone. It looks harmless, but it can ring at any moment, and there is going to be annoying salesman, so it's extremely dangerous, and we have to deal with it.